Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another video sharing lots of inspiration. Today I'm going to showcase the new release by Altenew. They have released new washi tapes and die cut tapes as well as a lot of stencils. In this video I'm going to share cards using the die cut tapes and the washi tapes, but let's take a look at the stencils as well, and I promise I will make another video where you can see all of them in action. This is the Rose Bouquet stencil. It's absolutely adorable and probably my favorite from all these stencils. This is the Liquid Marble stencil and you can see the effect that it gives, great for backgrounds and adding interest on your cards. This is the Linear stencil. It is really intricate design and I think it would look gorgeous. I can't wait to use this one, and look at the back, how beautiful this background looks. Here is another favorite from this release. It is called Leaves and Berries, and I think it would provide a great background for any flower that you want to stick on top as a focal point, but it would make a card on its own, as you can see at the back. If you love geometric shapes and honeycombs, you will absolutely love this one. It gives a lovely background. And here is another background stencil, perfect for this season. This is called Diamond Snowflake Stencil and it is great for all your winter cards and even your Christmas cards. And finally, those two stencils are really unique. You can use them separately if you want, but if you combine them, they're going to give you a beautiful background. These are the classic pine stencils and you can see the effect that they give. And I promise I am going to come back with another video using all the stencils so you can see them in action. But now let's take a look on all the washi tapes and the die cut tapes that have been released today. Let's start with the die cut tapes, which are really unique. So this one is called Bouquet. This is actually a sticker, so you can easily peel it off and stick it on your projects. And it gives that beautiful lace look. Also, although it looks very intricate, it's not as delicate as it looks. It is really sturdy since this is not paper and it doesn't tear off as easily as you imagine. Moving on to the next die cut tape, this is called Graph and it gives you that grit. Again, this is a sticker so you can peel it off and stick it on your projects. And let's take a look at the last of the die cut tapes that have been released. This is the Vibrant Spray. It gives you a beautiful flower arrangement. And again, it is self-adhesive, so you can peel it off and stick it on your projects. If I had to choose a favorite out of the three die cuts this month, I would definitely go with this one, and you will see that I'm going to use it in three different cards out of the five that I'm sharing today. Now let's take a look at the washi tapes. This is the Deco Lines and it has a lovely foiling. I'm going to show you the ones that have foiling on top of them first. This is the Gilded Greenery, really gorgeous. There is foiling at the tips of all those leaves. And finally, this is the Golden Dodge, a really big one that covers up completely a card front. And finally, these are the Gradient Lines and the Calming Bouquet. Now I'm going to share 5 cards using die cut tapes and washi tapes from this release, and you will be able to see that these tapes are great when you want to mass produce cards, so I'm going to show you a few designs which are really quick and simple to make, but I'm also going to share some more complicated ones. So here I used a piece of gold mirror cardstock and I placed on top a piece of this washi tape so that I end up having a very thin strip of gold on each side of the washi tape. This way I am creating a lovely banner that I can stick on top of my card. It works either vertically or horizontally, and all you need to do is to add a sentiment and you have a beautiful, very elegant card that you can easily mass produce. I embossed my sentiment with anti-gold embossing powder, and the sentiment reads "Thanks for everything." It comes from the Sentiment Strips, which is a lovely set and I will be using it again and again on this video, just because it is very versatile and gives you lots of sentiments that you can work with. I used foam tape to stick down my embellishment. I also used my scissors to cut off the excess, and my card is done. The fun part about this design is that it is very versatile, so you can use it for any occasion. The second card is going to also be super quick and simple, so you can easily mass produce it. After all, this design is so gorgeous that you don't really need to do a lot on such a card. So I'm going to peel off a piece and I went for the red flowers in this particular design. I am going to cut off the excess. You can turn this panel directly into a card by just stamping or sticking a sentiment. I decided to make it to take it a step further, so I'm going to add some foam tape at the back and stick it on top of a red card base. And instead of red cardstock, you can also use any shade of green that you can find in the leaves. Now, of course, stamp your sentiment before you add foam tape at the back and put your card together. Now, the good thing is that I used my Misty so that I can stamp it again and again and get a good impression. The sentiment comes from the Fancy Greetings stamp set. It is a lovely sentiment stamp set. And now you can embellish it with gems if you like. I'm going to leave it as it is. I think it looks gorgeous in its simplicity. Now this washi tape is the Calming Bouquet. It is a lovely large washi tape that would cover up completely the card front of your card. You can use it as it is, like a background. Just stick a sentiment on top or die cut a sentiment like I'm showing you here. So just a couple of ideas on how to use a large washi tape. However, for this card I decided to do some fuzzy cutting and I'm going to cut out completely these flowers. I do leave a white border all around, which makes cutting out the flowers easier. After cutting out the flowers, I'm working a little bit on my background, and to add some interest, I added splashes of white gesso, and I'm going to stick the flowers on top by using foam tape at the back. Now, I am using my Nouveau Deluxe glue, and I'm going to stick this panel on top of a off-white panel. If you notice, the border on the flowers is not completely white, so I tried to match that off-white or cream color. And finally, I'm sticking down a sentiment that is white embossed on black cardstock. It reads "Make a Wish" and it also comes from the sentiment strips. Now, to finish off my card, I'm going to add some gems, and I have some that match the color of the cardstock. And here is the finished look. Now for the next card, I'm going to combine two of the die-cut tapes. So this is the graph one. I'm going to cut out a piece, peel it off and stick it on black cardstock. These die-cut tapes are really forgiving, so if you stick them wrong, you can always easily peel them off and stick them back on. I am using the grids on my glass mat to make sure that everything is nice and straight, and of course you can use your scissors to cut off the excess or just stick it at the back like I did here. Now I'm going to use the Vibrant Spray die-cut tape and I'm going to use my scissors and do some fuzzy cutting. I want to cut out some of the flowers and they are going to be the focal points on this card. I didn't even peel off the packing and I have foam tape at the back. I created a flower arrangement there and somehow I lost the footage of sticking everything down, but it is quite straightforward. It is an easy card to put together. The only time-consuming part is when you cut out the flowers, but their design is quite loose, so you don't have to cut them out perfectly, and I didn't even leave a white border. And just because I absolutely love the Vibrant Spray die-cut tape, I'm going to use it for a third time, and this time I'm going to cut it out with my paper trimmer. So I'm going to eyeball it and cut it out about in the middle. Now, if you do that, there are many ways that you can stick them on your card. For example, here I'm spreading them out, leaving a white gap in between, so that you can stick your sentiment there, or you can stamp the sentiment, and you will see that I'm going to do something different. You can also stick all those borders towards the edges, and this is going to give you a lovely border on each side. For this card design, I decided to stamp the sentiment on a different piece of cardstock and stick it on top. This way you spread out the design and make it look as if it was bigger, although there is a gap underneath. To finish it off, I'm going to add some sparkle by using some gems in a green color that matches the colors of the cardstock and the leaves. And here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. Now, this video is part of a blog hop as we celebrate this new release, so make sure to visit my blog as there are lots of giveaways to be won. Thank you all so much for watching today. I hope you had fun and that you got inspired. Just like always, you will find the list of all the supplies used down below in the description area. Don't forget to leave me a comment and let me know which one of those die-cut tapes was your favorite. See you all next time!